Hi, today I'm going to go through the market numbers for January 2021 in Colorado Springs. This will cover just the single family homes in just Colorado Springs, but it'll give you an idea of what's going on in the market. I'm sure you've heard things are tight, so we'll go through all those numbers so you get the real thing. And then stick around for the end because then I'll go through some suggestions for sellers who are concerned they don't want to sell because they aren't sure they'll be able to find a home. And for buyers who are in a tight market and looking at possibly going up against other buyers for the same house. So stick around for that at the end. There'll be some good ideas for either one of those groups. In the meantime, be sure and subscribe and hit that little bell so you're notified every month or every time we do a new video, which is about every week. We do stuff for working, playing, and living in Colorado Springs here. And here's my contact information. I'd love to hear from you with your suggestions, your ideas, your questions, anything at all. Let me know what's going on. So let's get started. All right, here's last month's numbers. We did sell 632 homes. That's down just a little bit from last year. Not that much, but not very many homes sold, but we did have, that means 632 buyers found a home. 632 sellers were able to sell their home. So that's not bad for 1 month. And here's some good news. The listings were actually more than that. It's 734 new listings, which is down almost 15% from last year, but it's 100 more homes coming on the market than going off, which we haven't seen that for a while. So that's a good thing. Still moving pretty quickly, 18 days from the time the sign goes in the ground to going under contract, and that's down a third from a year ago, January. So at the end of the month, there was only 359 single family homes left for sale. That's down over 57% from last year. That's a big drop in available homes. So we'll see if we can get some more people to list their homes this month. The median price, of course, is going to keep going up as the supply is low and the demand is high. So we're at $380,000 now is the median price. So that means half of them are selling for more than 380 and half are under 380. And the average is over $432,000 in Colorado Springs now, up 13% from last year. So if you're a seller and you don't think it's a good time to sell because you won't be able to find a place, let me give you a couple of ideas. First of all, you can ask for a longer close. The typical is 30 days, but it doesn't have to be. That's about the minimum time to get the loan figured out, closed, the inspection done, and the negotiations are done after that, the appraisal done, all that kind of stuff takes about 30 days. But you can ask the buyer who's desperate to find a house, how about 60 days? How about 75? You can move them out and they'll probably say yes if they don't need to move right away because they found their perfect home and you've got it and you just need some additional time so you can find your house. Or you can also ask them for a lease back. This means that, for instance, if you're going to close on your selling home on April 1st, you can say, hey, Mr. and Mrs. Buyer, I need to rent this back from you for another month. I want to rent this from you for the month of May. So I'll just stay in my house. I'll pay you some rental money maybe, and then you can move in at the 1st of June, and that'll give me time to find my new home. So let's work on that maybe. Also, another idea is find an Airbnb or a corporate rental that's furnished. You can get those by the week or the month, and that might be a good thing for you. So you've got a place to go when your house sells. Or you might consider a new home altogether. Once you put your money down, that's yours. And you're locked in and you know when it's going to be done. And so you can time that with the sale of your house as well. Here's a search engine for you. I'll put this in the notes, and you can just put in, I want a house from 350 to 400,000. I want four bedrooms, three baths, and it'll pop up everything that's available, either that's already built or under construction or in the planning stage. And then you can search through there and maybe find your new home that way. So buyers have a different thing. They're going to be up against competition, probably stiff. So the first thing they need to do is get pre-approved for a new loan. This is more than the pre-qualification that you get over the phone. This is after you've put in all your paperwork here. 2 years of tax returns usually. your proof of income, that kind of stuff. They want to know exactly that what you can afford. And then they'll give you a pre-approval letter, and that will lock in exactly what they're willing to lend you. You've also got to have your earnest money and your down payment and your inspection money ready in the bank, because those are going to come out of your pocket before this thing starts. So make sure you've got that all set up. Then, here's an idea. Consider how homes below the maximum you can afford. So if you're pre-qualified for 400, say, you might consider looking at homes from 350 to 375. Let's say you find a house at 365, you go under contract, somebody else comes in and says, I'm gonna up you to 368. You can go, well, that's all right, I'm gonna go to 372.5. And you've got a lot of cushion still before you're out of money. And so you'll probably, if they're at the top of their limit, you've got some cushion there. So that's something to consider. You don't have to spend every money, every bit that the bank is willing to spend you or lend you. And again, maybe a new home is what you want to do. You've got a lot of time to look for it. There's no competition. There's no buyer competition for you. Once you put your money down, that is yours. You're locked in, and nobody else can get it from you. And again, here's that search engine for you. I'll put this in the bottom so you can see what's going on. So that's it, the wrap for January 2021. I hope some of these ideas are helpful for you. Here's a couple of other videos about Colorado Springs you might be interested in looking at. Again, another invitation to subscribe to this channel so you keep up with working, playing, and living in Colorado Springs every week. And here's my contact information. Love to hear from you. Give me an idea, a question, a problem, and I'll work on that with you. Hope to hear from you.